Hi friends, welcome back to Let's Play Full Throttle. So, we got some gas, we found Mo's blowtorch. Now all we gotta do is find some new forks. So now, you're probably wondering, how do we get in? Well, it takes a little ingenuity. Or maybe not ingenuity, just sort of thinking a little bit outside the box. What the? Okay. This is a little weird. Something has captured my... Okay, something's gone weird here. Just a minute. Alright, note to self. Do not just... leave, Oh, what the... Okay, let's see if this works a little better. Yeah, much better. Okay, note to self, don't just alt-tab out of this program and do stuff with the camera program. It doesn't work very well. Anyways, so, how to get into the junkyard? Well... kinda gotta think out a little bit outside the box.
This should be easy.
Yeah, except so, instead of going in the door, we go over the wall. Junk.
Love that line.
He isn't just a biker, he's a motorcycle aficionado.
Fire damage. Forget about it.
Ooh, yeah. Fire damage, yikes.
Just the kind of forks I need, right on top.
Excellent, maybe this won't take so long. Oh crap!
Dog.
Yeah, remember that big dog he mentioned?
It's red-eyed, too.
Yeah. I remember that line.
Well, the dog does no longer appears to be in the junk pile.
True. See if we can do it now.
Apparently the dog doesn't like you going to that junk pile.
No, it's not just the junk. It's not that just that junk pile.
It's if the dog sees you.
There were There were bolts flying out of his mouth.
He's been chewing on stuff.
I guess.
So, where do we go?
Cars. No, thank you.
Where'd the dog go?
We don't know. Well, I don't know. Maybe if we distract him?
Dog jumps in car, eats meat, jumps out, kills me.
Maybe not. What's over here?
Probably the dog.
Well, yeah.
Is that a magnet?
I've actually never heard that line before.
Whoops, walked a little too far in.
Nuts and bolts.
Yeah, no. No. Down. Down. Down, boy. It's down. Well, we did see a huge magnet.
Or something. Okay, the crane can be operated. Alright, reasonably simple controls. Yep, that's a magnet, alright. Aha. Now we have an idea.
So how do we get the dog into the car?
That's where the T-bone comes in.
Yep. Gay for long-range movement controls.
Yeah. It's nice that they didn't make Ben look like an idiot. Or not. Oops.
Just click up there.
Yep. There's a ladder over there, I forgot. Now we just lift him up into the air a little ways.
Now you can see the car on the end of the...
Yeah. Right over here.
I wish it would scroll quicker, though.
Scroll quicker?
Scroll sooner.
Yeah.
Well, we got our handlebars.
Forks.
Forks.
Nice forks. Where'd you find them?
Right next to the knives and spoons.
Well, that's it. Wait outside for a minute and I'll finish it up.
There's a kid there.
Hey, no, that's the reporter.
I'm going to ask you, what's this picture of?
Oh, that's me and my Uncle Pete. shortly after Dad split at this place he called the Mink Ranch. When he died, he left it to me.
You're a mink farmer?
Nah, that place went belly up long before he died. But I still go back.
Roger. Come
there whenever I need to get away for a while.
Okay. Just curious. Now I'm out of here. Mo's almost done with my bike. Maybe there's a chance I can stop the ambush.
Ambush? Really? Where?
Somewhere between here and Corville. My crew is escorting some VIP.
That's how she got us over.
Thanks for the lift. Now I got a quote for you.
All right, here she comes.
If that quote is anything like I think it is, it's not going to be printable. That look. You're amazing.
I should crash that thing every day. What's the surprise?
Oh, just your average everyday pre-regulation destroyer class solid fuel recoil booster.
You're serious?
Yes.
I'm only the vultures.
I have my connections. Now, are you going to try this thing out or not? Holy cow, wish I had a camera.
I wish I had some way of being your back.
Just beat it, will ya? You're scaring away my regular customers. Send me a postcard from the ambush.
Ben? Maybe you should have wheeled the thing off that platform first.
She's probably used to it. This reminds me of the intro sequence when I'm on the road.
I'm indestructible. Nobody can stop me.
Whoa, roadblock.
The gas tower. Alright, so how do we distract them?
Hit the gas tower again?
My thoughts exactly.
I mean, you hit the gas tower, the alarm will go off, and they're like, oh, they're here! Goodbye.
Shh.
What?
Don't give it away.
Saying what they'll probably do.
Hear that? He's back at the gas tower. He's got a lot of nerve and a piece of trash.
Damn right I do.
All you just follow me.
I'm also smarter than you. Heck. See ya!
Ben, how'd you get behind us? Where are the suits? Corley's making a pit stop. He has a bladder the size of a thimble, man. Ripperger? Haven't seen him in a while. Ben, man, what's the deal? Did you find something up the road? Are we headed for trouble?
No. We're in it. Damn zipper! It's like you need a new pair of suit trousers, dude. He did.
You shouldn't have laughed at me in those board meetings, Malcolm.
Oh, excuses, excuses.
Gotcha. Hey, what I found in the bushes. What is that?
It's a chokehold. Come here and I'll demonstrate.
The rest of the Corley family?
Crap.
Ben. I guess Burger couldn't wait for night.
Cough?
Just like him to hit a man when he's flying.
Even dying, he still gets a laugh in. Minivans? Ugh.
You gotta hurt him for me, Ben. Promise me you'll hurt him bad.
I promise.
Yeah, he's an old biker.
You have a daughter?
Yeah, she's a real mechanical genius, Ben. We built her first carburetor when she was four.
Damn.
We used to call her the diaper dynamo. Find my daughter, Ben. Find Marine.
That look is priceless. And give Mo points for perception here. Gray eyes, very unusual. My little brother used to have gray eyes when he was really young. Why are you wearing your shades in the middle of the night? Well, now we understand why she...
What's that moving over there by that pile?
I don't know, Rick, but I think that pile is Boats.
Yes, now I remember. You're the smart one, aren't you? There's Mo Shack, but I don't see the logo. Maybe I'll be there.
Well, I guess now we understand what she was talking about when she described her shop as a renegade Corley operation. Nothing to see in here, I guess.
Looks like someone searched this place in a hurry. Nothing left but debris, except for that smashed up camera.
That's open. No film inside.
Mo said she didn't have a camera. Here's Mo's picture of her and Uncle Pete at his mink ranch. She said she went there whenever she needed to get away for a while. That's pretty much my only lead right now.
Sounds like a good enough place to hide. I mean, maybe out in the open, but it's out in the outback.
Plus it's, maybe it's kind of private. Oh, yeah, right.
What are you doing going there without your bike, man? Yay for turbo-boosted bike!
That thing's got some serious horsepower. Oh, whoops. I'm not really wanting to go to the bar right now.
To the left?
Right.
Why do you have to drive all the way back around to there? Turbo-boosted bike!
Ooh.
So much for returning to the scene of the crime.
Really?
Coming this way soon. I gotta get a plan. Fast.
Yeah.
Yeah, now they have a murder case on their hands.
Yeah.
Check out the bar.
Yeah,
have
that's...
you seen Maureen? Go the other way from the bar? continue down the street of the bar?
I don't know, let's see.
Wait for the command sequence to appear.
Looks like not so much. That's pretty much the edge of the edge of the world, it seems like. A semi.
This sucker's mine. Look, I really need a ride.
Nobody's in there. Maybe somebody who owns that is in there?
Seems reasonable.
Hey, killer.
What? Huh? No.
Once again, our top story tonight, Malcolm Corley, owner of Corley Motors, was found dead at a rest stop just outside the town of Melonweed. Apparently, the benevolent patriarch and CEO was viciously beaten about the head and neck.
This report, this news anchor is awesome.
Police have arrested a notorious outlaw biker gang known as the Polegats.
No.
With the exception of their leader, who is still at large. Roadblocks have been set up along Highway 9 in an effort to apprehend this dangerous and violent criminal.
We've been set up. Roadblocks suck. I shouldn't have left the gang there. Yeah, I don't want to hear anything about it. You ain't making me an accessory after the fact. Just lay low, man.
I'm afraid I can't do that, Dave.
It's empty. Don't get any ideas. I'm not putting my lips on that. Nothing to
that
grab.
Guy is busy playing the knife game where you poke it between your fingers as fast as possible.
I'm not putting my lips on that.
Why not?
Yet. Gotta ride. No.
Members of the Polecat gang are in custody, but their leader remains at large. Authorities have issued an all-points bulletin.
They got the Polecats.
Well, looks like that ain't giving any help.
Doesn't have any controls. Yeah, the signal spiked into the Kickstand National Headquarters. High-kicking was never my move. I've never liked nose rings. Me neither, but someone dared me. Look, let me tell you what happened. I told you I don't want to get involved.
Nah.
Hey, can you give me a ride?
He doesn't look happy.
Said he doesn't like roadblocks.
He's got a knife. He's got a knife. Put your truck out front. I need a ride.
I look like a cabbie to get lost. They're not letting anyone do that roadblock anyway.
Not even truckers.
They turned me around, said police business only.
Pigs. Am I distracting you?
I can do that.
Not go to him.
Let me show you how to do that.
Not go to him.
Let me show you how to do that.
Not go to him.
Look, I really need a ride.
Not go to him.
Why? Because you're afraid of some cops. I just killed a guy. I'm just about to. I don't think that's good for the table.
Hey, Quoho.
Yeah, Emmett.
I'm gonna be knocking up your table for a while, alright?
The customer with the knife is always right.
Case in point. Oh, hey.
I need to get to this place. Uncle Pete's Mink Ranch.
I need to go in that direction, too, but the pigs are well in the sky tonight.
How poetic.
Yeah, really. Out of curiosity.
Ever hear of this place? Uncle Pete's Mink Ranch?
Well, I remember it used to be
I mean, hey, you never know. Mink meat may be, perfectly reasonably nutritious.
I wonder where that kid ran off to.
She's not a kid. Nope. She's a reporter.
Yeah. Short, though.
Hmm? Yeah, she's short, like me.
You gotta help me. Go find my editor in Corville. Tell him I took pictures of the Corley murder.
You got pictures?
Yeah, but some thug took my camera.
So you don't have any pictures?
Well, I tracked the guy to Melonweed, but I'm not going near the place. They kill me. Get my editor. He's gotta get me out of this. Take one of these fake IDs to get through the roadblocks.
Damn. That is a lot of fake IDs.
My career is riding on those pictures. Help me, Ben. You're my only hope.
Oh, don't worry. I know you want.
In my innocence.
Grin.
Miranda's thug is the same in the trash most places. That could be Miranda's camera I saw there. But then, who's got the film? I'm not putting my lips on that. Oh, is wood.
Go away. You're blowing my cover.
Trucker will be happy if he can get through the roadblocks, won't he?
For sure.
But they're not going to trust a man in a car, especially since they know what you look like. Why do you give it to the television?
Just to see what he says.
Here. What's that? The fake federal investigator ID could be of some use in one of those roadblocks.
Hmm.
So how about a ride? Search the back and find my bike. It's buried in a pile of concentrated fertilizer powder. Trust me, no one's moving that crap. Now you're gonna ride in the engine compartment.
The engine compartment?
Hey, I smuggle stuff in there all the time. Stuff your carcass in there quick and we might hit that meat dump by morning. Hope you're better with a stick shift than you are with a knife.
Yeah.
Right, ass marks.
What?
Oh, great.
Right.
Smells like he's got a fuel leak.
Sparks.
I love engine fires.
Yeah.
Yeah, squeaky brakes.
Fertilizer. That was the engine compartment.
Loose hose and nothing big. I already pulled the bike out.
It's just me, or does he seem a little nervous?
Uh-oh.
My thoughts exactly, Ben.
He did have a fuel leak, and he took my fuel line to fix it.
Oh! He did not!
Do not mess with a biker, friends.
Oh, yeah. Especially not the leader of a biker gang.
He may be one more reasonable of a biker gang.
The barn's locked. The barn's locked. Open up, you minx. I'm not putting my lips on that.
The back way?
I think we're gonna stop here for today.
See ya.
Yeah, we're gonna have to figure out we're gonna have to find a new fuel line or figure out a way to get ours back.
Judging from the fact you drove off, that don't seem likely for a while.
Hey, one way or another. Later, folks.